Ahead on Newsnight, it is a beast of a job, but someone's got to do it. Newsnight's Nissen goes to Broadway, and he may not be on Broadway, but he's still a star. This program, The Rooster in Morning Papers, coming up as well. As the curtain rises on another Segment 7, Broadway takes a bow, safe tonight in knowing that a strike has been averted. Actors reached a tentative agreement with producers on wages and work rules and outsourcing, all that traditional stuff that any working stiff worries about when he heads to the shop, punches the clock, and puts on his furry nose for the night shift. Here's Newsnight's Beth Nissen.
Steve Blanchard is on his way to work.
I work nights and weekends, and on occasion a midweek day.
Six evening performances, two matinees, the standard Broadway work week.
Since 1996, I have been in Beauty and the Beast on Broadway, and since 1999, I have been the Beast.
Been the Beast for 5 years, more than 2,000 performances. He clocks in about 2 hours before curtain, begins the transformation from suburban dad to bearish brute.
It takes them about a half hour for makeup right off the bat.
To attach a beastly nose.
Good. Mm-hmm.
A prosthetic chin with attached fangs. His face is encased in latex and spirit gum. His head and neck will be covered by a heavy mane.
It's extremely hot and sweaty. The only things that are really exposed are my cheeks, my eyes, and a little bit of my forehead.
Moving, singing as the Beast involves hard physical labor.
At the end of the first act, the Beast climbs up this huge, enormous set and sings this big, you know, power ballad.
No point anymore, I can love her.
Sometimes, you know, hauling the 30-pound costume, you get to the top and you're like,
let the world be done with me! Let the world be done!
Physically, it is the most demanding thing I've ever done in my career.
Setting as the sun.
From the orchestra seats, his job looks glamorous, starry. But work on a stage can be as repetitive as work on a factory floor.
You go to work the exact same time every day, do the exact same thing every day, sit in the same chair every day, get the same makeup put on every day, put the same costume on every day, and then go out on the same stage and say the same exact lines every single day.
When Guinevere heard,
like millions of conscientious employees, he strives to keep his work fresh. It helps to have occasional changes in co-workers, leading ladies playing the role of Belle. In 5 years, he has played opposite a carillon of different Belles. And every time the curtain goes up, the audience is new.
Because those people change every day, it creates a whole new atmosphere every single day.
One by one.
Enough people are still coming to Beauty and the Beast, now in its 10th year, to make the show a Broadway staple. Yet Blanchard says he, like millions of his fellow American workers, knows no job is secure.
An actor always knows that any job they have is going to end. One day it's going to stop, it's going to end, and you go to the next one. In order to be able to work, in order to be able to support your family, to, you know, to pay the mortgage, you got to go.
In the meantime, he is grateful to have such a good job. Grateful there is still a market for the product he and his co-workers manufacture. A few hours of art and music and magic.
That's what we make for the audience. We make a memorable, moving experience.
Beth Nissen, CNN, New York.
Morning Papers after the break.